swinging. Mr. Untouch.
Oh, nice. Great combinations. I like the way he's...
Oh!
Oh, solid jab.
And a knee! Vicious knee.
There's that knee.
There it is again. Hard shot from the clinch. Just 2 minutes remain in the fight.
Good inside leg kick.
Strong hook to the body by Mr. Untouchable. And he takes this fight to the ground. Man, some nasty body shots. And you can see the bruising starting on the left side. Really good movement on the ground. Half guard. Ramirez gets it back to the guard.
Nicely done, reversal. Reversal and into full guard.
30 seconds.
He's got his back now.
He's got full mount here. Big left hand. He's got his back.
There he goes.
Back to mount again.
This one goes the distance. What a battle.
And let's take a look at our fight replay.
Round one, great accuracy on that shot. A lot of great striking throughout this fight. Round two, brutal ground and pound topped off with this elbow. Round three, look at the force generated by this knee to the head.
And here's Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Judge 1 scores this contest, 29-28 from Ramirez. Judge 2 scores it, 29-28, Mr. Untouchable. And Judge 3 scores it, 29-28, for the winner by split decision, Mr. Untouchable.
Mr. Untouchable earns the victory by split decision.
Welterweight showcase between Mr. Untouchable and the Warrior.
The Warrior coming off a great training camp and feels outstanding.
This guy is a boxer, and he will have a distinct advantage if this fight goes in boxing distance, whether it's up against the cage with dirty boxing or in the center of the octagon where he can utilize his superior accuracy. I'm a real trucker.
The Warrior enters the octagon. Mr. Untouchable, pumped up, very confident, and ready to battle in the octagon.
This guy is extremely well-rounded. His submissions are world-class, his striking is excellent, and he is extremely unpredictable in what attack he chooses to go with.
thinking it's alright. You playing with that pole, and you gon' know tonight. You laying on that pole. Dirt getting tossed in your way.
Mr. Untouchable is ready to battle in the UFC's welterweight division. Our tale of the tape for this welterweight bat. This is a very even matchup. Everything between these two fighters is virtually identical. And with the official introductions, here's the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 158 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, Gonzalez! And now introducing his fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 160 pounds. Fighting out of Buena Park, California, Mr. Untouchable. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta, our referee. Ready. Mike Goldberg, Joe Ready. Rogan. We are set for the start of round number one. Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for the Warrior. Black trunks for Mr. Untouchable.
Oh, man, with that right leg kick.
Connected there. Good movement to the right.
Hard one to the body.
The Warrior with the combination. Punishing roundhouse kick. Joe, we're really starting to see the accumulation of those body shots and the damage.
Good job landing the series of strikes here.
He's able to block the punch.
Nice body kick.
Swinging early, both men.
He's got the clinch.
Great trip for the takedown. Mr. Untouchable's going for a submission.
And he escapes the submission. He gets in a full guard here.
Great transitions on the ground. And he lands with the left.
Beautiful, into mounts. Hip escape. And he's out of the full mount. Nicely done. And he winds up on top. Looking for the rear naked choke. He pops out of the rear naked choke. Very nice sweep. Winds up in his opponent's guard.
Ah, that's an outstanding transition.
Looking for the rear naked here. Trying to get it. This arm bar looks nasty. He might have to tap any second now. Oh, that's it. That's it. That's it. He got him. Brilliant. An excellent job in setting up the arm bar and getting the tap.
Time now for our fight replay.
And we see here, as soon as this arm bar gets locked in, there is no escape. Perfect technique. Tremendous pressure. And one more time from this angle, we can see that arm bar locked in tight for the... And here we see it again. Beautiful submission victory.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 52 seconds in the very first round. Declaring the winner by tap out due to an arm bar...
Mr. Untouchable gets the submission victory here tonight.
You call it a hobby, I call it a way of life, a way that you can stop. You know that I've been training, right? The more you try to block, the more that I control the fight. And now you on the ropes, now you on the ropes, what you gonna do?
Coming up next, it's a heavyweight showcase between Big Daddy and El Toro. Way out of the tunnel, and he looks very prepared for tonight's fight.
This guy is a wrestler. He likes takedowns, he likes control, dirty boxing up against the cage, and if he gets the fight to the ground, look for him to ground and pound with devastating punches and elbows.
Ready to go to battle inside the octagon.
USA!
Big Daddy, as he makes his way towards the octagon, he knows he needs to put on a good show tonight.
This guy is a very well-rounded fighter. He does not mind standing or going to the ground, and this diversity makes him very unpredictable.
Big Daddy, ready to go to battle here at Madison Square Garden. Take for this heavyweight collision. Big Daddy is 19 years his elder. He weighed in at 265 pounds. He will have a 4-inch reach advantage. With the official introductions, the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is for rounds of the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a wrestler. Make his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 231 pounds.
Fighting out of Mexico City, Mexico, Hernandez. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a boxer, making his professional debut here tonight.
He stands 62 inches tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. Fighting out of Buena Park, California, Big Daddy. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta, our referee. Mike Goldberg, my partner is always Joe Rogan. And we are set to get things started. Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for El Toro. Black trunks for Big Daddy. El Toro's opponent is so much taller than him. Joe, what does he have to do to try to counter him?
He's got to figure out how to get inside. He's got to get inside the long range of his opponent, get inside the strikes, and work the body. He's fainting with that kick.
He was set up perfectly to block that hook. Good right-left combo there. Nice job slipping the punch.
Both fighters are tentative here, Mike, really respecting each other's abilities.
Excellent jab by Hernandez. Swing and a miss. Under three on the clock, round one. That right hook misses.
Wow, what a back and forth exchange. Doing an excellent job of mixing up his strikes here.
Looking for the single.
Oh, and down. There we go. Look at this. He's out of it.
She's going to step right back over. Nice right hand.
He's got full back mount now. He's working from full mount again.
Vicious
nasty elbow lands to the head.
Huge bomb from the top.
Gets out of the full mount. Now he's in full guard.
He's going for a guillotine. Under a minute remains.
Looking for the choke, looking for the choke.
Looks like a tight guillotine here. It looks fairly close.
That choke is deep.
This may secure the victory.
I think it will.
It's over. Round was almost over, but he sunk in the submission and got the victory.
Joe, here's the finish on our fight replay.
Let's see it again here. Got the choke, it's in deep, and no choice but to tap. Let's see it again here. Deep guillotine choke, full guard for the tap. And one more time, nice technique here on this submission.
And with the official decision, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta is going to stop this contest at 4 minutes, 43 seconds of the very first round. We're going to win it by tap out. We will be a team choke. Hernandez!
El Toro earns the win by submission.
Showcase between Ghost Dog and El Tigre. El Tigre makes his way out of the tunnel, and he looks ready to go.
He's a very disciplined striker, Mike. He's got great, well-rounded fundamental skills and always comes in with a smart game plan and sticks to it. He's got a lot of respect for every opponent he faces, and he has the mental toughness that you just can't teach.
El Tigre enters the octagon, set for tonight's fight. Very confident that he will come away with a victory tonight.
This guy is a very well-rounded fighter. He can do it all. If the fight takes place standing or on the ground, he's going to be comfortable in all areas of the game.
El Tigre. Our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight fight. Both fighters are 24. El Tigre is 3 inches taller. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage.
With the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC Light Heavyweight Division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a boxer, making his professional debut here tonight.
He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 187 pounds. Fighting out of Mexico City, Mexico, El Tigre.
And now, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a boxer, making his professional debut here tonight.
He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 204 pounds. Fighting out of Mexico, Russia, Ghost Dog. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
Herb Dean, our referee for this light heavyweight battle, here tonight in New York City. And here we go.
Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
White trunks for El Tigre. Black trunks for Ghost Dog. Nice roundhouse kick to the body. Oh! El Tigre's kick just misses.
Both fighters a little bit hesitant to engage, feeling each other out.
Ghost Dog with a good right hook.
They are exchanging here, Mike.
Great use of the kicks.
Nice jab, very snappy jab.
Trying to shoot.
Nice leg kick.
Trying to connect on that jab.
And he completes the single. Nice transitions.
Oh, very bad. Full mount. He gets his back.
Flattened him out.
He scores with a huge left. Oh, that one hurt him.
And the mount again.
Hip escape. Nice hip escape.
And again, he's back into side control. Got the mount again.
Postured up.
He gets his back again.
1 minute on the clock.
Flattens him out. Nice punch. He's back to full mount again.
That
huge
was a
elbow
nasty
lands to the
elbow.
Head.
Don't be flat. Yeah. Yeah. Go down. Hold you down. Keep moving. Keep moving.
20 seconds.
Looking for the arm bar. Can he finish his fight?
Nice right hand.
Big right hand.
What a good first round.
Let's take a look at some of the action from that round. And here's a nice shot, lands perfectly. And here's another clean shot that lands. And another perfectly placed strike. You could really see how awesome that round was by these highlights.
And the lovely Brittany gets us started for round number two.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Round two.
Nice leg kick.
Good kicks, Joe.
And there's a nice straight by Gostov.
The swelling on his eyes is starting to get really bad.
Here's the left. He's leaving it open for the left.
Very nice leg kick by LT Gray.
That connected.
Backing the head kick. LT Gray with a hook to the body.
Both men landing in that exchange.
Joe, if he doesn't start to defend these heavy head kicks, this fight could be over very soon.
Yeah, no doubt about that one.
Misses the takedown.
They're working hard here in the clinch.
Good knees.
Nice knee. Very nice. Well placed.
He's in a better position here with the tie clinch. Looking for a takedown. Ghost Dog with a nice punch.
Scored on the body shot. Man, he gets some torque on that hook.
He's taking some shots now.
Joe, we're seeing some nice work. He's really staying busy.
Look at that. He's timing that jab.
Joe, we can see the game plan here. Punish his opponent's leg with some vicious kicks.
He's got him down. Very nice sweep.
Watch out. Trying to lock in the choke.
And he gets out of that rear naked choke. He transitions to full mount.
LT Gray with the good punch. Oh, big right hand.
Huge left hand.
Solid elbow from the top.
It's all over! Nasty ground and pound KO.
Let's check out the action on our fight replay.
And let's look at the replay and see the end of this fight. This is the huge ground and pound strike that lands for the KO. Let's look at it from a different angle. Watch this again here. Boom! And he's out.
With the official decision, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean's called the stop for this contest at 3 minutes, 53 seconds of round number two. Declaring the winner by knockout, LT Gray.
LT Gray, victorious with the knockout. Octagon tonight and set to leave with the UFC featherweight championship belt around his waist.
As he makes his way towards the cage, his preparation has been perfect. He is in fantastic shape, had an amazing camp, and he believes that he is in the perfect position to become the new champion of the world. As he steps into the octagon right now, he steps in with a champion's mindset.
Set to enter the octagon to defend his title.
The champion is in focus right now. He's making his way towards the cage. His training for this bout has been perfect. Everything ran according to plan. He believes he has a solid game plan, and he's ready to step in here and retain his title.
Kid Dynamite enters the octagon for our main event of the evening. Our tale of the tape for this featherweight championship fight. Both fighters are 24. Hercules is 2 inches taller. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Hercules. The moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from Madison Square Garden in New York City, it's time for the undisputed UFC Heavyweight Championship of the World. If you
This man is a wrestler. Make his professional debut here tonight.
He stands 5'9" tall, weighing in at 140 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, USA, introducing the challenger, Hercules.
And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a boxer, making his professional debut here tonight.
He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 136 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC featherweight champion of the world, Kid Dynamite.
All right, this is for the championship. You can give me your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves is making
fun. This is a fight that we have been looking forward to for a long time and is about to take place right now. I'm very excited.
And here we go. Our championship fight tonight is scheduled for 5 minute rounds. White trunks for Hercules. Black trunks for the champion. Joe, we have seen many title fights over the year, but few have been as much anticipated as this matchup. Bad blood back and forth, two of the best fighters ever to compete in the octagon. Only one man will leave with the belt.
This is one of the most important title fights of the year, if not ever. An absolutely massive and important world championship bout. There is a lot on the line here tonight.
Oh, that head kick caught us. Good right left. Great job with the roundhouse.
Big shots. He's really doing a good job of controlling distance and getting off these shots.
Changing stances. Hercules with a good knee.
He's doing a great job of being unpredictable.
Nice jab. Joe, that's a solid hook to the body.
Roundhouse kick lands. And there's a takedown attempt.
Kid Dynamite with a big jab.
Head kick. Oh!
He can't connect with the kick. Oh, that's a big straight. Dynamite gets caught by the kick to the midsection.
That's a good kick. Solid leg kick. He lands a clean combination.
He can't connect with the straight left. Front kick to the body by Hercules. And another strike lands. He avoids the clinch. Nice jab by Hercules. He blocks the punch.
Oh, look at that.
combination.
Hard left hand.
Round one complete.
Beautiful strike here, lands on target. There's a nasty kick to the body. There's a powerful kick to the body. Some really well-placed strikes on display in that round.
Brittany.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Second round.
At the end of that round, his opponent was clearly hurt. He's going to look to start this round off fast and try to pick up where he left off.
Good uppercut.
Big roundhouse kick. Strong kicks by Kid Dynamite. Solid jab. The number of leg kicks landed. Kid Dynamite's really using them to slow his opponent down.
Oh, head kick!
Hercules with a punch that connects.
Very good exchanges here.
Combination by the champion. He's circling to his right here.
Yeah, he's digging into that leg kick.
Back and forth. And he lands the punch.
Man, he just missed with that straight left. Hercules with a good straight right.
Locks up the Muay Thai clinch.
Absolutely vicious!
Big punch from the top lands. He dove into that shot. Hard jab.
Connection with the straight by Kid Dynamite.
And he lands another one right there.
Good counter with the left. Head kick.
Oh! He's doing a good job of throwing punches and kicks from all angles here. Really doing a great job of mixing things up.
The huge head kick is blocked.
That bruise on his torso is getting bad.
Good kick to the leg of his opponent. Nice left hand.
Oh, he caught him.
Oh!
Oh!
Right on his head! Head kick! Hard straight punch. Oh, huge kicks!
Big kick, just missed. Good right by Hercules.
Changes his stance.
Joe, those feints are really setting up effective combinations.
Wow.
Final seconds of the round. First takedown of the fight. Round two in the books. Man, the champion landed some big shots in that round. It looked for a second like the fight was going to be over, like he would leave once again with his belt. Instead, the battle continues.
Here we see that again. And let's see that again from another angle.
finished the round. Nice.
Way to go. Listen, you almost had him finished, but the round came at the end. Now let's start this next round off and finish it.
There's Ariani as we get ready for round three.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Start of the third round of this championship fight. Great job blocking that punch. Kid Dynamite with a solid kick. And he connects. Oh, did he snap that kick? That's a big hook. Nice uppercut. Vicious combination. Big punch. And he's throwing that left hook with ill intention. Great jab by Kid Dynamite. Kid Dynamite's continuing to punish that wounded eye. And you can see that the swelling continues to get worse and worse.
He's absolutely targeting that eye. You can clearly see, and he's landing combinations on it repeatedly.
Switching his stance up a little bit.
Misses with the kick. Oh. Man, that was a big strike.
Big shot.
The champion in pure survival mode. Can he continue?
Powerful jab. His other eye is starting to swell. More great kicks from him here.
Kid Dynamite switches his stance again.
Oh!
Nice straight left by Hercules. Joe, that's another solid kick. Nice right hook by Hercules.
Didn't quite connect.
Hercules gets caught by the inside leg kick. And he continues to mix up his strikes.
Nice front kick to the body.
Big roundhouse kick. Solid kick to the body by Kid Dynamite.
Closing the distance. He's got the clinch, Joe.
Oh, that's a strong Muay Thai club clinch.
Knee to the body by the champ.
Oh, looking for his back.
Oh, and reversed.
Full side control.
Round three is complete. Hercules has got a cut on his cheek, and it's nasty.
It's on his cheek. He can't let it distract him. It's not the worst place in the world for a cut, but I guarantee he's going to be aware of it. And here's another head kick. And here's one more perfectly placed head kick. Lots of action in that round.
Ariani helping us get set for round number four.
Ready to fight? Ready.
Ready for the start of round four. This fight scheduled for five-minute rounds. Joe, we have made our way to the championship.
Oh! Can he finish it? He hurt him there, Mike. Big right hand. He hurt him with that hook.
Back and forth battle.
Nice jab.
Head kick. Beautiful hook.
Oh,
Joe, another strong jab.
Big roundhouse kick. Kid Dynamite gets hit with that kick to the midsection.
His left eye's closing up.
Nice work in the clinch. Good body shot by Hercules.
He's landed some really big shots in this fight. Big power shots, and that's what's winning the fight for him.
Oh, beautiful sweep. Hercules with a good punch.
He takes it back.
Half guard.
Now he's mounted up.
Now able to posture up. Kid Dynamite gets caught by that.
Wow!
And what it is all over!
Got the full mount and dropped some vicious bombs from the top for the KO.
Time now for our fight replay.
And let's look at the replay and see the end of this fight. This is the huge ground and pound strike that lands for the KO. Let's take a look at it again. Look at this. Bam! Nighty night.
Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop this contest at 2 minutes, 35 seconds of round number 4. Declaring the winner by knockout and new undisputed UFC featherweight champion of the world, Hercules.
Hercules is the new UFC featherweight champion.
Pass in all slow-mo. You don't get the nod, you'd rather not even know me. Cause even me existing is killing your bitch mojo. I dance like a JoJo, I cut a rug to a hole. Polo undies got my in a tote. I'm off the stalk in the smoke. A jukebox cut off without coins, I'm a magical bloat. A babacuti, a chunk for the simple fact that you don't know how to float. Another tragedy, I'm a bad new man, babe. I'm armed with a your mom's got a new lease on sight, a new home.
It's not your fault, baby. We were just here born to shine.
Big boy, just pull up, flight club, foreign or domestic. International pair, but also locally respected. Savannah, chillin', pimpin', drippin' and stankin' like the juice do. Since baby needed pampers and that leg and needed a new shoe. Make them call me BB King because I get that bitch to lose. Now they down on Biddy D because they wanna move the jewels. And I'm slick, bout to run up on them smooth with the sticks. Take a couple Polaroids to capture the moment. Now she's caught up in the rapture of this Megan. Where your home went? In the back of the Cadillac, she laughing as her skin is showing. As a matter of fact, I'm about to splash your life Pacific Ocean. Lots of loving in the place I call Johnson's.
It's not your fault, baby. We were just here.
It's a welterweight title fight between Assassin and Grandmaster. Grandmaster, set to enter the octagon and take out the champion and leave with the UFC welterweight belt around his waist.
As he makes his way towards his cage, he believes this is his time. He believes he is destined to take this title. His preparation for this bout has gone absolutely according to plan. He's in fantastic shape with a great game plan, and he expects to walk out of this cage tonight as the new champion.
Assassin, making his way to the octagon, looking to defend his championship belt.
The champion headed to the cage right now is in the groove. He is in his prime right now. His training for this bout has been perfect. He believes he has a solid game plan, and he's ready to step in here and retain his title. He is well prepared for this contest.
Assassin is ready to defend the UFC welterweight belt. Our tail of the tape for our main event of the evening. Both fighters are 24. Grandmaster will have a 3-inch reach advantage. And once again, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. Is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from Madison Square Garden in New York City.
This man is a mixed martial artist making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, presenting the challenger, Grandmaster. And now it is the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Buena Park, California, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending UFC welterweight champion of the world, Hunter.
All right, this is for the championship. You can give me your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. You will have a clean fight. Touch gloves, let's make it official.
Assassin.
You ready to fight?
Grandmaster. Ready. Here we go. Championship fight. 5 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Grandmaster. Black trunks for the champion. Grandmaster with a hook to the body. He changes his stance. Carter circling right. He's switching it back and forth. Carter got caught by that left. Big roundhouse kick.
Great exchanges.
Very slow and methodical.
Missed the mark.
Ah, nice straight punch. Assassin with a good leg kick. He lands a hook from the clinch.
and right into the Muay Thai clinch. And there's another knee. Man, they've done a lot of damage tonight. Good hook by Carter.
Look at that!
Nice reversal here.
Oh, he sweeps. Look at his position now.
Side control.
2 minutes remain in the round. Ah, nice sweep. Very good movement.
He does have full guard here, which is still dangerous.
Grandmaster with good connection from the bottom. Postures up. He went right back to that position. Back to half guard. And he connects here. Carter's unable to pass. Under a minute.
Oh, Joe, great sweep. Now he's in a dominant position with side control.
He's got half guard. He's now working from half guard.
He's got it. Full mount. Look out for the arm. Look out for the arm. He got his arm free. He hip escapes. He's out of the full mount.
Full guard now. And the round comes to an end. Really nice movement on the ground.
Okay, listen. This time we're taking this guy.
And here we go. Let's take a look at some of this action here. Here's a powerful knee that lands and causes the knockdown. And here it is again. And let's look at that again.
The lovely Brittany.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Second round. As this battle continues, the champion.
Big front kick landed. To the face.
Wow! Unbelievable!
Oh. He's out! He's out!
It is all over!
What power that guy has in his hands.
Once again, here's our fight replay.
Let's take a look at the replay. This is the shot that drops him. Perfect technique. He's clearly hurt badly here. Let's take a look at it one more time. Here's the knockdown. Vicious strike. Check out this angle here. Boom! And then he's out.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean's called a stop to this contest at 16 seconds of round number two, declaring the winner by knockout, and still the undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Hunter
Assassin, remains the UFC welterweight champion. Heavyweight title fight between Big Train
and Boom Boom. Looking to beat down the champion and leave tonight as the new light heavyweight champion.
As he steps towards his cage, he understands this is one of the biggest moments in his life, the biggest moment in his career. He is looking to take this title, and he believes his time is now. His preparation has gone perfectly. He is in outstanding shape. He has a great game plan and a great camp, and he believes that he will emerge the new champion of the world tonight after this fight.
Making his way to the octagon, looking to defend his belt.
The champion is in focus. He is in his prime. He's making his way towards the cage. His training for this camp has been absolutely spectacular. He believes he has a solid game plan, and his mentality coming into this fight is clear and focused.
That's a fight, Boom Boom. Our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight championship fight. Both fighters are 24. Big Train will have a 2-inch reach advantage. Once again, here's the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from Madison Square Garden in New York City.
This man is a wrestler. Make his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'8" tall, weighing in at 186 pounds. Fighting out of Irvine, California, presenting the challenger, Boom Boom. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the corner. This man is a Muay Thai fighter. Make his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 187 pounds. Fighting out of New York, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC light heavyweight champion of the world, Big Train.
All right, this is for the championship. You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves this week.
So we are finally set for one of the most highly anticipated matchups in UFC history. Joe, an outstanding build-up to this fight, and it's finally here. Title fight. Five-minute rounds. White trunks for Boom Boom. Black trunks for the champion. Oh, he lands the roundhouse to the body.
Nice jab.
Joe, he continues to put together great combinations. To the body. Big Train switching his stance.
Nasty knee to the body. Oh, stunning jab. Big straight punch.
Yeah. That explosive jab. Good exchange. That's a great job stuffing the double leg takedown. Boom, boom. Gets tagged with the right.
Looking for the takedown. Wants the single.
Oh, he's got him down.
And in guard.
Great movement on the ground.
And the clinch.
They separate.
He's fainting with the punch. Shoots the head kick, but misses.
Nice hook to the body by Boom Boom. And again, he lands the body shot.
Oh! He's in trouble. He's in trouble.
Big power jam.
Hard straight punch.
Big shots.
Missed. Oh, big body kick. He blocks that hook. He scores with the leg kick.
He connects on a nice combination.
Wow, what a great job mixing things up. Oh, and another powerful leg kick. He's looking to slow his opponent down.
Absolutely.
Final seconds of round one.
Nice Superman punch.
Round one is complete. We were so close in that round to seeing the champion defend his title. This top contender dug deep. He survived. And I mean, that's what he did. He survived to fight another 5 minutes.
Here's a vicious kick that results in a knockdown. Let's see this again. And let's look at it from a different angle.
Brittany gets us set for round number two.
Ready to fight? Ready.
Round two.
Starting off this round, you gotta think he's probably still hurt from that last round. He's gonna wanna move and avoid taking damage early. Good body punch there.
Faints with the kick.
These guys are just standing in front of each other and throwing bombs.
Nice straight right by Boom Boom.
Oh, big head kick.
Again, Joe.
Vicious shot to the body.
What a jab.
Powerful strikes.
Oh, he's landing some good shots here. Kick, but miss.
Looking for the single.
Grab the leg, completes the takedown. Boom Boom gives up his back.
And back to the mount.
And great posture.
He tags him with the punch.
Full guard now.
Beautiful timing with the left hand. Wow, quick movement on the ground.
Now he's back into full guard. Lands a good shot from the bottom.
Boom Boom's back in half guard.
excellent movement on the ground here, always trying to better his position.
Now he goes north-south.
Looking for the choke.
And he got his head up.
And he moves into the mount.
Boom Boom screws on his body, continues to get worse. It looks ugly.
The mount again. Postures up. Oh, nice good left hand.
Big Superman punch. Oh.
Going ahead to round three.
Let's take a look here. There's a nice leg kick. And here's another beautiful leg kick. And there's another excellent leg kick.
The lovely Ariane here tonight. Inside Madison Square Garden in New York City. Third round of this championship fight. We continue this championship fight, and so far so good for the top contender. He has worked so long and hard for an opportunity to be a UFC champion, and I think it's safe to say that so far he's been the better fighter.
Boom Boom caught by that head kick.
Wow, what a back and forth exchange. Nice shot.
Boom Boom's eyes are both starting to swell up.
That was a brutal right leg kick, Mike. He's got some outstanding kicks.
Joe, we go inside the numbers. Total strikes landed. Boom Boom with the jab. Nice job with the roundhouse. Joe, he changes his stance.
Nice counter right hand. Got the Muay Thai clinch. Knees are coming. Knee to the body by the champ. Nice sweep. Beautiful trip. He's in half guard here. Into full guard.
Good shot to the body. Midway point of the fight, Joe.
He's looking to take the back.
He's got both hooks in.
And he's flattened him out. He's got the back mount here. He's going to flatten him out. Looking for the rear naked choke. He escapes the rear naked choke.
Big right hand.
In half guard position.
Big shot.
Brutal ground and pound.
Oh, that's a big kick. Oh, he's landing.
Rocked him with that right hand.
Big takedown.
You're in half guard. You're all good there.
Reversal. Very nice.
And he connects. Big Train's body continues to get punished. There is some serious bruising.
Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy.
Switching things up a little bit.
Good jab.
Big takedown late in the round.
Now he's in guard.
He's in half guard. Nice sweep.
Now he's in full guard.
That's the end of the round. In that big takedown late is a big statement on the judges' scorecards.
And there's a nice head kick that lands. And here's another head kick. And here's one more perfectly placed head kick. Very exciting round.
Ariani gets us set for round four.
Ready to fight? Ready.
We are in the championship rounds, the start of round number four. Joe, they battled for three rounds, and now we move to the championship rounds. What should we look for?
The championship rounds is what separates the good fighters from the great fighters, the fighters who work hard, and the fighters who literally dedicate every blood, sweat, and tear drop that they have inside of their body towards victory. This nice inside leg kick.
Big Train with some good kicks. Big Train's continuing to punish that eye.
Yes, he is. That's a good target for him. He sees the swelling, and it's going to impede his opponent's vision. Very nice counter. This cut in his face is getting worse.
Standing and trading. Exactly what we had hoped for.
Drop down for a double.
They got to stay busy, though, Joe. Somebody's got to go for something here. Nice movement on the ground.
He's moved to full guard.
He postures up and delivers some vicious ground impact.
Hit him with a jab.
He scores with a nasty inside leg kick.
Good inside leg kick.
Oh! Whoa!
Nasty elbow and he's down.
Big ground and pound. He connects with the left. Really good movement on the ground.
Full guard.
And he slips to half guard.
Huge elbow to the head.
He connects with the head kick.
The swelling in his eyes is starting to get worse.
Under a minute in the round.
In close inside leg kick. Head kick. 45 seconds. Oh, that hook did damage.
Nice left.
Safe for now. Big Train with the hook.
They have worked into the deep waters. Four rounds complete. One round remains in this UFC title fight.
Here's a devastating elbow that results in a knockdown.
Big Train starting to really bleed from his nose.
That's a bad spot. Nasty, right on the nose, and clearly he can see that cut. And let's look at that from another angle.
See, look at me. Watch me. Watch me, okay? Everything we work for.
The beautiful Ariani.
Ready to fight? Ready.
5 minutes on the clock.
Joe, this is the kind of fight that UFC President Dana White loves. Two men willing to bring it.
I think these guys are getting fight of the night bonus for sure.
Boom Boom with a strong leg kick.
Man, he has taken some heavy kicks. That left thigh is starting to show some signs of bruising.
Strong knee to the body by Boom Boom.
He's doing an excellent job of forcing the action and controlling the center of the octagon.
Yeah, absolutely.
There you see the total strikes landed so far in our fight.
Joe, nice knee to the body by Boom Boom. Oh, he tagged him with that strike.
They are exchanging here, Mike.
Huge block of that strike. Good defense with the parry.
And now they clinch up. Nice throw.
Side control.
3 minutes remain.
Big elbow. Oh, man, that is rough.
Big right hand.
Him with that right hand. He's out, he's out. Unbelievable, look at this. Got the full mount, secured the position, and dropped bombs.
Time now for our fight replay.
We can see it one more time from a different angle. Ground and pound at its finest, and that is the shot that ends this fight. Take a look at this from a different angle. And he's out.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 9 seconds of round number 5. Playing the winner by knockout and new undisputed UFC light heavyweight champion of the world, Boom Boom.
Boom Boom is the new UFC light heavyweight champion. What a great night of fights. For my partner, Joe Rogan, this is Mike Goldberg, saying so long until next time. We see you right back here, inside the Octagon.